Hello, I am Shondaya Solis, and you're watching Behind the Seal, your source for news and information from the city of Vicksburg. Today, we take an in-depth look of the major flooding that impacted so many residents of low-lying areas. Two firemen celebrate 30 years of service with the Vicksburg Fire Department, and the city of Vicksburg celebrates the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. All of these stories and more are Behind the Seal.
Hello, Vicksburg, and thank you for joining us today for Behind the Seal. I'm William Nettle. Many residents of Vicksburg and Warren County rang in the new year with news of an upcoming flood. Now, this news was surprising to many as we are accustomed to spring flooding in May and June, but not in the month of January. Here's Shondaya Solis and Mahershala Howard with our VTV team coverage.
Vicksburg Police Department has been hard at work preparing for the rising flood waters.
Okay, we're in the Kings community up at Fox Steel location at this time. We started about 8 o'clock this morning alerting all the residents about the anticipating flood in this area. This is one of our low-lying areas in the city of Vicksburg. What we have is about 6 officers going door-to-door alerting the citizens of the Kings community of the flooding that should crest at January the 16th. They're anticipating a 54 feet flood at this area. And we want to give all the residents the opportunity to move out, perhaps get their furniture and everything out of their homes so they won't be completely destroyed. We're going to be going down to the Cedars community as well as Green Meadows. Again, we're going door to door to every resident. We anticipate knocking on about a little over 100 doors.
Chief Armstrong is aware that some residents will not adhere to the warnings. Regardless of that, he says safety of all citizens is his first priority.
We just want to make sure the citizens of Vicksburg, Warren County are kept safe.
City of Vicksburg employees from both the water and gas and the sewer departments are working swiftly to keep the rising waters of the mighty Mississippi out of Vicksburg.
One, two, three. Every department that's around the city of Vicksburg is actually here helping out today. So the water department, gas department, sewer, street, right away, we all now teaming up together.
I just hope for the best and hope the walls will hold, and which they will.
Even though a state of emergency has been issued for the city of Vicksburg, Assistant Sewer Manager Percy Guy is confident that the flood walls will hold the water back.
It's better safe than sorry. That's the way I look at it. We've been here before, yes, I'm sure it will. Yeah, it was 2011 we put it up and they did it.
Well, then 2011 they did, and then they did a terrific job, and I know that they will this time too.
I'm Shondaya Solis, and this is Behind the Seal.
I'm standing on what's left of Ford Road, and as you can see, the flood waters are moving at a fast pace.
That house over there, they got caught and they got flooded and they moved. Another person moved inside there a couple years ago, and now I never heard from my best friend since.
The street signs and mailboxes are already halfway covered by flood waters.
They come across the road by what? About 2-3 inches across the road.
My grandma is still living inside her house. She already got flooded in 2011.
That's me.
During this 2016 flood, most residents have already evacuated while some remain in hoping for the best.
She might get flooded again, but we're hoping for the best.
I hope not.
The Vicksburg Police Department has already blocked off certain areas to keep residents safe from the flood waters. I'm Mahershala Howard, and this is Behind the Seal.
Due to the rising flood waters, employees of the Cameron Manufacturing Plant are encountering this road closed sign when attempting to access Laterna Road. Warren County Sheriff Martin Pace was there to explain to us the obstacles this road closure has caused.
We're located on Laterno Road. This is at Cameron Corporation off 61 South. This road goes to their main river plant, but it also goes to several private residences that are back there. There's one family that have chosen to stay. Their home is not flooded, but it is inaccessible by vehicle. They're boating in and out. As you can see behind us, the water coming over the road is has made the road inaccessible to traditional vehicles. We're expecting a crest tomorrow, 50.5, and then hopefully the water will be dropping back off fairly soon after that.
Just a few days ago, Vicksburg police traveled these very roads to warn residents of the rising flood waters. Today, however, they're only accessible by boat. Most residents of Vicksburg are not privy to flood conditions, but those who reside in low-lying areas are all too familiar with the rises and the falls of the mighty Mississippi.
This is one of the areas that, along with several other subdivisions, this is one of the areas that we have been patrolling by boat for about a week now, almost a week, as the water came up too high to travel this road by vehicle. Okay, we're on Chickasaw Road, just west of the city limits right now. We're actually riding above the road surface, which is about 7 feet below us. The homes that are in this area are either flooded or inaccessible. There's one home here that that is elevated high enough that the people did not have to leave, but they are having to boat in and out.
Sheriff Martin Pace and his deputies are riding the floodwaters every single day. They're doing this to ensure the safety of all of the citizens residing in Warren County.
And we're on top of what should be Chickasaw Road.
Now, most residents of these communities tell me that they will come back and rebuild and remodel as necessary. They're just thankful it's not as bad as the flood of 2011. From King's Community, I'm Shondaya Solis, and you're watching Behind the Seal.
We'll be back after this message.
Here in the River City of Vicksburg, we cordially invite you to check out all of our main attractions. From historical parks to children's parks, museums, galleries, great hotels, great restaurants, and shopping centers, we have something for the entire family. Here in the River City, we have a wide selection of things we know you would love to explore. Vicksburg, simply, uniquely Southern.
Welcome back. Well, we have a new president of the Chamber of Commerce.
All right, that's going to be your new president, and so Tom?
Director of the Chamber of Commerce, Jane Flowers, while being assisted by Tom Kendall, proudly introduced the new president of the Chamber, Lynn Foley.
I officially proclaim myself immediate past president.
Foley went on to express her gratitude while serving as vice president and how she's excited about following in Tom's footsteps.
And I sincerely appreciate the opportunity to have served as his vice president and the vice president of the Community Development Division. I've learned a lot from Tom, and it's an exciting opportunity to follow in his footsteps and continue.
Many residents of Vicksburg and Warren County recently came together to celebrate and to honor the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Although some may celebrate Martin Luther King's birthday as a day off, various volunteers and leaders from the community met at the Martin Luther King Monument to kick off a day of community service in the city of Vicksburg. Not only did volunteers clean the streets, but they also cleaned abandoned homes. They moved old debris, swept floors, and moved out old furniture.
Let's get a little muscle over here.
North Ward Alderman Michael Mayfield says it's plenty to be done, and it's all for a good cause.
Whatever we do, it is for the betterment of the city of Vicksburg. We're not here for show, form, or fashion. We're here to do a job. That's what it's all about.
Not only did Vicksburg celebrate Dr. King Day with community service, but Jackson Mayor Tony Yarber also stopped by to speak to our citizens here.
That money makes the world go round, and we'll shut this thing down until it goes round us.
Jackson Mayor Tony Yarber stood before many in an effort to encourage our community to make smarter financial decisions.
In the Asian community, $1. $1 stays in the Asian community for 30 days. In the Jewish community, $1 stays in the Jewish community for 20 days. In the white community, $1 stays in the white community for 17 days. How many days does a dollar stay in the black community? Come on, I'm listening. $1 stays in the black community for 6 hours. What you want is to purchase what they told you you ought to purchase. All right, let me just go on and bring it all the way home. Who told you you had to have a Michael Kors bag? This ain't black or white, Sheriff. This is our wives and our sisters. Who told you you had to wear Louis Vuitton? Who told you? Brothers, who told you that your shoes had to be Stacy Adams? Just say ouch. Or that they had to be Aldo. When there are shops in our community who's selling, who's producing the kinds of things that if we really need them, we would help ourselves to understand that money makes the world go round, and we'll shut this thing down until it goes round us.
Police Chief Walter Armstrong has a strategy to not only protect the citizens of Vicksburg, but to protect the police officers as well.
We are here to announce the Vicksburg Police Department policy and usage of body cams.
VTV attended a press conference with Vicksburg Police Chief Walter Armstrong, where he explained the new policies regarding body cameras.
This is a project that we started working on over a year ago. We were able to purchase 80 body cameras for each Vicksburg police officer with drug seized funds. We believe it's imperative that we can capture the work of the Vicksburg police officer as they go out and do their assignments across the city.
Chief Armstrong feels that the use of officer body cameras will not only keep our citizens safe, but it will also hold our officers accountable.
The body worn cameras are an effective law enforcement tool that can reduce violence, confrontation, and complaints against officers. Body-worn cameras provide additional documentation of citizens' contacts and are important tools for collection of evidence and maintaining public trust.
In addition to the body cameras, Vicksburg police officers also have a way to make traffic stops quicker and more efficient. Here's Officer Michael Battle with more information.
Dispatch, show me how. Traffic stop. Clinton Mission. Mississippi 28. Whiskey Boy after 400. Whiskey Boy after 400. Also run a Mississippi DL 801. 614-766-6666. Copy.
Back regular operator. Restrictions non-status is going to be suspended. Failure to pay the fine. Failure to show proof of insurance.
My name is Officer Michael Ball. I want to explain the new e-ticket system we have for the city of Vicksburg. It's a new system that we got for us writing tickets to cut down the cost of, the paperwork that we're doing. It's very simple. We, after the initial stop of a traffic stop, we pull a person's driver license. Most licenses should have what we call a barcode on the back, scan bar. Pretty much all the information is included in that bar. Take the license and we scan it in the scan box here. It's gonna make a beeping sound. Once it makes that beeping sound, we take it out and I go up here where it say last name. And I just hit that last name one time. And it's gonna pull up the last person that I just scanned, which would be Mr. Coleman. And I go here to Mr. Coleman and all I do is tap on his name and it fills out everything. Now up here, I had to put the street name that I made the stop on and the beat that I made the stop in. I had to fill those out. In the case that Mr. Coleman was driving a vehicle, I would go right here and just put in his tag. And all his vehicle information will pop up in here. All the red, the year, the make, the model, the type, the color, everything will pop up. Then I go down here in case Mr. Coleman was speeding. Let's say he was doing 52 and a 30, which would be 22 miles an hour on the speed limit. So I will go to the second one because he's doing more than 21. He's doing 21 to 29 miles an hour over the speed limit. And certain ones you have to do because each one is a different calibration of speed also. And I type that, then I come down and I put in the case number, which we call in and get from dispatch. Also, I will call in Mr. Coleman's driver license to dispatch to check and see does he have any local warrants, or is his license suspended, or for whatever reason, child support, or for any DUI, anything like that. After I confirm that he's okay, I come here and I put the court date and the court time. Hit add new. Coleman's ticket then would print out. My printer's here posted on the back of my board back here on my car, and it would print him a ticket. And it would look just like a regular uniform ticket with his court date time on it, with my name and badge number on it, and that's pretty much it. It's a weird, real, real good system. I love it.
Sir, my name's Officer Shows, Vicksburg Police Department. Can I see your driver's license, proof of insurance? The reason I stopped you, I saw that you wasn't wearing your seatbelt back there. Stand by for me just a minute, okay?
51 dispatch, you run a DL for me. Back regular operator, 10 white male. Restrictions none, status is going to be suspended. Failure to pay fine. Failure to show proof of insurance.
You realize your license is suspended? Can you step out of the vehicle, please, sir? Can you step out of the car for me, sir? Can you step to the rear of the car for me, sir? Turn around and put your hands on the car for me. Can you place your hands behind the back for me, please, sir? Sir, right now, you're being placed under arrest for driving while your license is suspended. Are your license suspended? If so, you can end up like this guy.
Today on the agenda, Fire Captain Harold Gaines and Battalion Chief Daryl Flags both celebrate 30 years of service with the Vicksburg Fire Department.
My name is Harold Gaines. I'm one of the captains of Vicksburg Fire Department. I've been a captain for probably 19 years. Been on the department for 30 as of today, January the 5th.
Good morning. I'm Assistant Chief Daryl Flags of the Vicksburg Fire Department. I've been a member of the Vicksburg Fire Department for 30 years on January the 6th, 2016.
The best kept secret in Vicksburg is this fire department.
In my 30-year period of serving the Vicksburg Fire Department, I have really seen the fire service as a whole, and especially Vicksburg Fire Department, evolve.
Had some rough times here, first starting off, and things were a little tough, and it's gotten better now. When I come on, the officers, black officers, it wasn't but two, and now you might have 20 or 25. Black officers in the whole department, including our chiefs now. We have black fire chiefs. And also we have the first black fire chief, which is now Chief Atkins. And he have been in charge now for almost two terms. And it's gotten better all around. Men are more subject to get along now. But in the past, we had some good people. They was excellent firefighters. We learned a lot off of them.
During my 30-year period, I have seen the fire service go full circle as far as it relates to safety and technological areas. When I first became a member of the Vicksburg Fire Department, we rode the back of the fire trucks. Took care of the entire city and county. We took care of some 200 square miles riding on the back of the fire truck.
I've seen it changing a lot of things, equipment. Like you see this fire truck that's behind me. That's the first new fire truck I ever driven. When I came on, it was those standard shifts, sticking the floors, Big Mac trucks, and that you go. May had them jumping when you drove them because you try to figure out how to drive those diesel engines where you've been driving those gasoline little small truck. Now you got to get in the big diesel, and the training have come up to a step where now they train you how to operate these fire trucks. You got classes to attend, so you know everything is very, very moved on in the future for quality, so we can have better service for the public. And the new equipment that we're receiving now that helps us and saves our life a lot. You know, it's been a good time here, 30 years been good. Met a lot of guys that I learned some things from, a lot of guys I had a good time with. And we're almost like family, some of us.
Some of the fondest memories I have here, I would have to say my coworkers. Some of the fondest memories I have that we all grew up together on this job. We was one family. This entire job was one family. We watched one another's children being born. We was there when one another's children were being born. We was there when one another got married, one another started their family. And I guess the fondest memories that knowing that some of these people, individuals that I worked with, I watched them grow up on the job as I grew up on the job and start their family, and now some of their children are a member of the Vicksburg Fire Department.
You know, it's just like a normal family. You got some sisters and brothers that probably shake your head at and say, man, we grew up together, but we still don't get along. And you might have that here, and then you got some guys saying, oh, man, that's my favorite sister, favorite brother. And you got some guys here, you say, oh, man, I could work with them for another 30 years if my body could take it. So, you know, it's been a long year. I've been through about, six or seven mayors and seen some changes in department heads and, over the city.
When I became a member in 1986, Even though the Mississippi State Fire Academy was established, we was not able to attend the Mississippi State Fire Academy. When I came on, all my certification was done through the city of Vicksburg. And saying that, that means that with my certification being done through the city of Vicksburg, I only could be a firefighter for the city of Vicksburg. They didn't have to worry about retaining me because I could only be a firefighter here. But fire service changed over the years. In 1991, the legislature enacted laws as it relates to career firefighters. And career firefighters, anyone who is a career firefighter must attend the Mississippi State Fire Academy and become 1001 certified.
But now we're more educated on our position. I don't know if the public know that we take a lot of classes and we're more educated on a lot of things that the fire service have to provide for the community. For instance, we got Fire Academy now. When I came here, you wasn't that much able to go to a Fire Academy. You had to take it in steps, go for certain weeks. Now these younger generation of people, they come in and they can do the full course. You know, I think that's been a lot of improvement that have been made through our training. We are more acceptable to some of the things that we face now. Because at first, you know, we had lack of training and we were scared to go up on some incidents. It was kind of afraid because we had no knowledge of it. And now that we go to school, we're taking classes in all various areas of the fire department. We have a lot of division that the community don't know about. It's not only firefighting that we do, fire suppression. We also serve in saving lives as far as EMT and paramedic, ambulance unit. Now it have grown since I came here. When I was here, we went with two ambulances serving the whole city and the county. Now you have up to four ambulances with paramedics on every unit and EMTs. So that's a great improvement that been since I came on. And now we are in various fields of rope rescue and we have water diving for saving people in ponds and lakes. We got the dive team. And we have a lot of things now that are available for the public. Like the public think we just firefighters sit around. We do various different things, wrecks, car accidents, and mostly helping the disabled. If some people call and say their mother or parent is unable to get back in bed or have fallen, we go over there and do a public service.
Once again, I say, being a member of the fire service, the income is needed to take our family. But the biggest thing about being a member of the fire service is it's a rewarding job. It is very rewarding knowing every day when you walked out of here that I helped somebody. I did something constructive yesterday. I made a difference in society. Somebody was in need, and I was there to help them. And I think that just as human, as a whole, that's one of the reasons for our existence. And I have a privilege to have a job where I can do that on a daily basis.
And that makes you proud when the public tell you, y'all done a good job. We like what you're doing. And that makes you good. That's the taxpayers, or your bosses, those real bosses. I consider the city officials my boss, but the big boss is the people out in the public, the taxpayers, and they really makes us draw chests out, stick our chests out when we really proud. It makes you proud to wear the uniform when the public give you comments.
When you leave here daily, you feel rewarded, y'all. It appears you get paid every day here because knowing the fact that you helped someone today is the best reward that anyone could have.
And they bring you things, cakes and cookies, and that really make you feel good, especially a lot of churches. They support us. A lot of organizations support us. So, you know, we figure we're not left out.
It's just a really good job. My experience with the Vicksburg Fire Department has been really great. It is a very rewarding profession. I have enjoyed all of my 30 years here, and it's just a fantastic organization to be a part of. I suggest any young individual who's graduating high school and not sure about what they want to do, I think the fire service is a great organization to join. The fire service is a great organization to join, and being a member of the fire service, it can help you bridge that gap until you decide exactly what you want to be.
Well, it's some good advancement for them, especially if they don't want to go to college or university. They can come here, fire police, deputy sheriff department, sheriff department, and it'd be a good career for them. I mean, we retirement from the state, and the retirement is superb. As far as I'm concerned, it's a superb. So if young people would come on here, they would see. One time when I was here years ago, 30 years ago, one man on the fire department made a statement. He said the best kept secret in Vicksburg is this fire department. Some of these young guys don't know that what a career they can make out of this fire department. You know, a lot of them jump the gun. Nothing to do around Vicksburg. I think I'm gonna go join the Army and Navy. But you can say here, if you just happen to not be needed in the United States military or whatever, you can come here serve your community, City of Vicksburg and Warren County, just by being on the fire department.
Once again, I say, being a member of the fire service, the income is needed to take our family. But the biggest thing about being a member of the fire service is it's a rewarding job. It is very rewarding knowing every day when you walked out of here that I helped somebody. I did something constructive yesterday. I made a difference in society. Somebody was in need, and I was there to help them. And I think that just as human, as a whole, that's one of the reasons for our existence. And I have a privilege to have a job where I can do that on a daily basis.
And I'd like to thank the public for all these years, you know, serving them, for allowing me to serve them. City of Vicksburg for allowing me to do 30 years to serve the city of Vicksburg. So I'm very contented with what I've done. You know, I stayed around and had some bad days and had some good days. Had a lot of the good days, though. So, you know, it helps me out a little to figure the good days were better than the bad ones.
This has been Behind the Seal, your number one source for news and information from the city of Vicksburg. For VTV, I am Shondaya Salise. Thank you for tuning in.